Eventually, all of Greenland will be ice-free in the summer. This summer in the north, we have seen for the first time open water very close to the north tip of Greenland. It's completely unusual, so this summer was warm. No ship has yet navigated around Greenland, but that's coming any time now. That will be open. So the Greenland, of course, will have a central role in what is happening in the Arctic and when can you sail straight over the North Pole in the summer. That will really save a lot of shipping to go that way.
What we've seen in the Arctic, which makes it very different from most other areas, is that it's been a very quiet area with very soft power between Russia and the US, even during the Cold War. When a new player such as China enters, that can sort of stir the pot in a way that the Americans won't like.
China has stated very clearly in its Arctic policy white paper published in January 2018 that it is interested in the Arctic shipping route. China defined itself as a near Arctic state that has rights in navigation, in exploitation, etc. in the Arctic.
China's words and actions raise doubts about its intentions. Beijing claims to be a near Arctic state, yet the shortest distance between China and the Arctic is 900 miles. There are only Arctic states and not Arctic states. No third category exists, and claiming otherwise entitles China to exactly nothing. Because the Arctic is a place of wilderness, does not mean it should become a place of lawlessness.
The relevant U.S. criticisms on China's role in the Arctic are the complete opposite of the truth, and it runs counter to the general trend of peaceful cooperation in the Arctic. It's completely confusing right and wrong and has ulterior motives. China has always had an open, positive, win-win attitude towards matters in the Arctic. When it comes to Arctic issues, we continue to be a leader in scientific research, advocate environmental protection, and make reasonable use of governing conduct according to law and international cooperation.
The investments is all right as long as there's no strings. When Chinese go to Africa to do their investments there, it's always with conditions of a political condition, and that is not acceptable from a communist dictatorship.
In 2014 and 2015, Chinese companies got some licenses and shares in companies that's already in Greenland. And that was also a result of Greenlandic government courting Chinese investors. So with these Chinese state-owned enterprises and private companies, they're looking for overseas natural resources as a strategic long-term asset for their companies development. And that's how they got into the mining businesses in Greenland.
The Kvanefjeld mine will be mainly a rare earth mine, which is used in superconductors, iPhones, electric vehicles and other areas.
A lot of focus is placed on the Chinese because they do control a significant amount of supply. But that isn't through the control of resources. It's through technical proficiency and processing. And this is something that they've invested in terms of the research and development going back a number of decades. And quite simply, as a result, they're 10 years ahead of the rest of the world in processing technology and ability to produce high purity metals and oxides and a cross-section of alloys. And that's really been their key advantage.
As soon as you get a foothold within the Arctic, even though if it's just indirect through mining, oil, other areas, that will also give you a voice in the Arctic.
There is a worry in America, but also in Denmark and Greenland, of this Chinese possible infiltration in the country. And I think that's very important that we give President Trump the assurance that we will not let that happen.
It's really a sense that maybe other countries have kept their eye off the ball through not investing in downstream processing and advancing technologies. They've just relied on these metals being available from the China system.
Monitoring the situation is probably what needs to happen. I don't know how you counter it. I mean, frankly, look, if the Chinese want to invest in mining in Greenland and the American interests do not, that is what it is.
We want investments, and especially when Pompeo, he was saying that you know, we should say no to Chinese investments. I think it's very important for the U.S. themselves to bring investments, because in Greenland we don't have all the investments that we need.
I don't think the Chinese have undue influence over the Greenlanders at this point. I don't.
We would like to have collaboration with the U.S., both when we talk about defense, but especially when we talk about investment. It would be interesting to talk about tourism.